This is part 4 of a tutorial showing how to edit with iMovie. In the previous video, I covered how to begin modifying video clips and photographs in a movie project. In this video, I'm going to cover how to add text titles, transitions, and backgrounds. Let's continue to adjust footage added to this timeline. To add text, we select the title browser here, and iMovie provides some canned options, which you see in the library. And I'm going to select this one, which is a centered title text, and I'm going to drag and drop it right on top of that first clip showing a mangrove stand on the island of Yakushima in Japan. And what happens, you see that a text track has been dropped and it appears as a blue bar above our footage. And over in the viewer window, you see the text where we will type in the title. I'm going to type in Mangroves of Yakushima. And to change that text, we double-click the text track, which brings up font options. Now we can change the style of the font. The size of the font, text alignment, additional features such as bold, italic, and outlined. Clicking this button opens a color selection. We can pick one of the standard colors or match a color in the footage by selecting the eyedropper. That opens a magnifying glass that we can hover over an object in the frame. Click once, and that color is applied to the highlighted text. If you want that exact color available for use later, then drag it to one of the stored colors. Now it's a simple matter to apply that color to the second line of text. But I would advise you not to get carried away and try to match your text titles to each clip. It's much better to stick with white or black or some other neutral color and font and be consistent throughout your movie. To revert to the default for this title, click the reset button. Let's play that clip. We see that the text fades in, and then it will fade out. If we want the text to appear for a longer duration, we just drag the trim bar at the end of the text track to the time we want. Or if we want the text title to span two clips, we just drag the end of that track across into the adjacent clip. And you can see that it will play across those two clips if you want that to happen. Let's add a different type of text title. Perhaps you wish to define a term or identify a species or person. We might use this one. I think it's more efficient to identify people and their titles or affiliations this way rather than having that person introduce themselves on camera. This way, the speaker can spend their time on camera talking about their topic.
So this stand is composed of trees belonging to the genus Candelia. But which species? Candelia candle or Candelia abovada?
Now that you understand how to add text titles, let's next look at backgrounds. One set of options includes maps. I'll pick one to illustrate how these work. Just drag one into the timeline where you want it to appear. You'll notice that a dialog automatically appears above the viewer window. Here you can set the origin. I'll type in my location and it appears. Then I'll see if Yakushima is listed. And there it is. Now when we play that clip, there's an animated route set up between those two locations. Or you can import your own map with whatever details you need. Another type of background that comes in handy are these images that provide a backdrop for text, for example. Sometimes we might want to interject a question in the form of text instead of having the narrator ask it. And I'll use this gradient and drag it and drop it into the timeline. Then we'll go back to the title library and drag one of these on top of that background. Now I'll type in my question. Let's see how that plays. And that looks pretty good. Another adjustment you might want to make is to add some transitions between clips. To do this, we select the Transitions browser, and you can see all the options below in the library viewer. I'm going to select the cross dissolve and drag it and drop it between these two clips. And you can see the icon for that transition type in the timeline. And when we play it, instead of an abrupt cut, it's going to cross dissolve between those two clips. By double tapping on that icon, the inspector opens up. We see that the duration of that transition is 1.5 seconds. We can change that, make it longer to 2 seconds, for example. And we can apply it to just this transition or to all transitions in the project. To get rid of it, make sure it's selected in the timeline and hit delete on your keyboard. This action turns it back into a cut transition in which there is an abrupt cut from one clip to the next. Now, there are a lot of other transitions in the library, and you can have fun trying them out. You can easily preview each one by scrubbing through it in the library. There may be one that works particularly well in your video, but don't go crazy and use a lot of different types of transitions. Stick with simple ones such as a dissolve or cut transition and use it consistently throughout your project. Okay, that's a brief look at how to add text, backgrounds, and transitions to your movie project. In the next part, we'll look at how to add audio.